Okay, then let's discuss the concept of aromaticity. What are the different aromatic compounds? And what is basically aromaticity? We need to have certain criteria. The molecule must be cyclic. It must be planar. Means all the atoms in the molecule should be in the same plane, means should each and every atom should touch the plane of the paper or the board. Then the molecule must be fully conjugated. Doesn't mean that you need to have So next one is, the molecule must follow Huckel's rule. So what is Huckel's rule? It must be having or containing 4n+2 pi electrons. When n is zero, it will be having 2 pi electrons. N is equals to 1, you substitute successively 2, 6, 10, 14 pi, etc., etc. These are the four conditions a molecule or species or ion should follow to be aromatic. Then first three conditions are same, but if it is having 4n pi electrons, then you can say the compound is anti-aromatic, cyclic, similar to aromatic, planar, similar to aromatic, conjugated system, similar to aromatic, but the only difference is 4n pi electrons. Whereas for aromatic compounds, you should have 4n+2 pi electrons. Whereas for anti-aromatic compounds, you will be having 4n pi electrons. For aromatic, 4n+2 pi electrons. In other way, you can say even pairs of pi electrons for anti-aromatic compounds, odd pairs of electrons for aromatic compounds. This is another way of saying. If any one of these first three conditions is violated, without bothering about the number of pi electrons, I'll repeat. If any one of the first three conditions are violated, you call it as non-aromatic compound. Whether it is non-cyclic or non-conjugated, or non-planar, then you can say the compound is non-aromatic. Okay, so the best example is called as 6-aniline. What is aniline? It is an unsubstituted monocyclic hydrocarbon. Simply you can say a conjugated cyclic polyene, monocyclic polyene is called N-aniline. N stands for the number of carbon atoms in the benzene, in the molecule. Let us say 6-aniline means there are 6 carbons in a cyclic ring that should be monocyclic unsubstituted. So you should not have any substitution. So you should have a conjugated polyene, monocyclic conjugated polyene is called aniline. So the simplest one is 6-aniline, which is also called as benzene. So benzene satisfies all the conditions, so therefore it is aromatic. So this is the molecular energy MO diagram. Don't bother about this one, but we'll focus on the Frost-Musselin diagram. So if you can look at all the electrons are in the bonding molecular orbitals. In the BMOs, no electron is in anti-bonding. That's the reason why it will have wonderful stability. Then if you can look at the 4-aniline, 4 carbon atoms, 2 pi bonds. So it is having 4 pi electrons. So therefore it is anti-aromatic, 4N rule. 4N plus 2 means aromatic, 4N anti-aromatic. But if you can react this with a lithium, it will abstract 2 electrons. It will become a dianion. So you will get 2 pi electrons. 2 plus 2, 4 non-bonding, what you call it as, it will, once it is in conjugation, they could be called as pi electrons. So therefore it will become aromatic. So it will become aromatic, cyclobutadienyl dianion. Look at here. So this is 8-annulene. It appears to be anti-aromatic. Why? Because cyclic appears to be planar, etc., etc. It is having 4N. That means 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 to 8 pi electrons. It is having 4N pi electrons. So appears to be anti-aromatic. But anti-aromaticity is a destabilizing force. It will destabilize the molecule. That's the reason why what happens is it will take a different conformation. It will become non-planar. It will acquire a tub shape so that to escape from the destabilizing effect of anti-aromaticity. Itla unti the anti-aromatic avutundi nana. Kabatti very unstable. That's the reason why em chesthe then conformation marchukuntadi. Tub shape ko chesthadi. So then it will become anti-aromatic. I'm sorry. So if it were to be planar, it is anti-aromatic, but it will change its shape to tub shape, will become non-planar. So therefore it will become non-aromatic. So chudagane manam anti-aromatic and tick chestam. It's very important, you must remember. So cyclooctatetraene is non-aromatic. Remember, this is non-aromatic, boat shape, the tub shape. So this will become aromatic either by losing 2 electrons or it can gain 2 electrons. Dication is also aromatic, dianion is also aromatic. It will become once again planar. It will acquire a planar shape. This is non-planar. It is a tub shape, non-aromatic. Look at here, 10-annulene. So these are called annular hydrogens. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 3 plus 2, 6. 3, 4, 5. 5 means 5 to the 10. It appears to be once again aromatic, but these two are called annular hydrogens. I'll repeat. These two are called annular hydrogens. This one. This one. And also this one. So these annular hydrogens, because they come closer due to steric interactions, repulsions, the molecule becomes non-planar. So the once again, this is also 10-annulene is also non-aromatic. So it will become non-planar. It is non-planar, so therefore it is non-aromatic. So let us remember cyclooctatetraene and also 10-annulene expected to be aromatic. That is expected to be anti-aromatic. This is expected to be aromatic, but because of the non-planar conformation, it is non-aromatic. Remember these two things. This is 12-annulene. So because it is anti-aromatic, not stable even at minus 50 degree centigrade. So once it becomes aromatic, stable even at 30 degree centigrade, that is the effect of the aromaticity, that is the strong stabilizing force of aromaticity, right? Like this, you can work out later 14-annulene, 16-annulene, whether they are aromatic or not. Bridged annulene, sometimes we call them as homoaromatic. To make the total system aromatic, this bridged carbon goes out of the plane of the remaining portion of the molecule. So this called as homoaromaticity. This is called homoaromaticity. We'll discuss once again this one. So then we have another classification, what is known as benzenide and non-benzenide compounds. If at least one benzene ring, compounds have at least one benzene ring, you call them as benzenides. Remember, when you are asked to find out the number of resonant structures or canonical forms, look at the number of vertical lines. How many vertical lines does it have? So it has only 2. Forget about the pi bonds. 1, 2. So 2 resonant structures. What about this one? 1, 2, 3. 3 vertical lines through 3 resonant structures. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It has 5 vertical lines. So naturally it should have 5 resonant structures. This is only for benzenide structures. For benzenide molecules, you can simply guess the number of resonant structures like this. I'll repeat. Count the number of vertical lines, only sigma, 1, 2, 3, 4. So it will have 4 resonant structures. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 resonant structures. So aromatic compounds can be anions, can be cations, we have seen. So here, look at here. So one pair is part of the ring, the other pair is not part of the ring, just like you will be doing in heteroaromatic compounds, isn't it? So what are quasi-aromatic compounds? If they ask in detail, in depth if you go. So which of the following is a quasi-aromatic compound? If either positive or negative charge is part of aromatic ring, then you call it as quasi-aromatic compound. Best example is cyclopropenyl cation or cyclo. This is also there. This is the classic example. Cyclopentadienyl anion, which is part of ferrocene. So this is cyclobutanyl dication. So this is aromatic. Even dianion, dienyl dianion is also aromatic. Those are quasi aromatic. Yes, this one. So this is also aromatic. This is also aromatic. This is a popular tropelium cation, cycloheptatrienyl cation. Cycloheptatrienyl cation. Problem ఏంటినన్న అన్మ్యూట్ ఆప్షన్ ఇస్తున్నా డౌట్ ఉంటే అడగండి చాట్ పెట్టచ్చు ఓకే అన్మ్యూట్ ఆప్షన్ ఇచ్చాను సో దిస్ ఈజ్ అరోమాటిక్ సైక్లో హెప్టా ట్రైనైల్ కేటయాన్ సో దిస్ ఈజ్ ఆల్సో అరోమాటిక్ ఆల్ దీస్ ఆర్ అరోమాటిక్ ఇన్ స్పైట్ ఆఫ్ హ్యావింగ్ చార్జెస్ సచ్ టైప్ ఆఫ్ కాంపౌండ్స్ ఆర్ కాల్డ్ క్వాసి అరోమాటిక్ కాంపౌండ్స్ దెన్ వి హావ్ వాట్ ఈస్ నోన్ యాజ్ ఫుల్వీన్స్ అండ్ ఫుల్వలీన్స్ This is called as exocyclic double bond, called as exocyclic double bond. In such cases, such a type of compounds, we call them as fulvenes and fulvalenes. Here an interesting thing is, remember, so sometimes one ring may be aromatic, another may be anti-aromatic. Are you getting my point? So in such cases, polarization will not take place and overall system is non-aromatic. Here, look at, so this is also aromatic, 2 pi electrons. This is also aromatic, 6 pi electrons. So this part will become cyclopentadienyl anion. This part will become cyclopropenyl cation. Both are aromatic. In such cases, total system is aromatic. You remember this one. So when you have an exocyclic double bond, particularly with cyclo, what you call as pentadienyl system, you call it as fulvene, called as fulvene. Okay, so this will be stabilized. Look at here. Why? Because negative charge will be part of this ring, positive charge will be located here. So naturally, donating groups will stabilize this one. So here, this is the reverse way. Why? Because negative charge is located on this carbon, positive charge is part of ring. So therefore, withdrawing groups will be stabilizing this one. Sometimes they can ask, which is most stable? Are you getting my point? Look at here, which ring is going to be, is ring going to be carried with the positive charge or negative charge? And what about the charge and the rest of the molecule that is outside? This is having a positive charge outside. This is having a negative charge outside. We know negative charged species, that is carbanion is stabilized by withdrawing group. And carbocation is stabilized by donating group. Is that clear? These are some more examples. So this you can study in detail in separate chapter. These are some heteroaromatic compounds. Look at here. This is part of the ring. Only this pair is part of the ring. So therefore it will become aromatic. Yes, homoaromaticity, just now I gave an example. See here, if you remove one proton here, what happens somewhere, or you add some proton, what happens? This pi electron this pi bond will be removed. That means two electrons will be removed and that will be bonded to H plus. So what happens is, so at one place it will become sp3 carbon, at other place it will become sp2. So therefore, it can completely delocalize provided this goes out of the plane of the paper. So oka carbon out of the plane ellipothe remaining anni kuda they will be part of the ring. So they will be stabilized by the resonance. So in such a case we call it as homoaromaticity. A compound that contains one or more sp3 hybridized carbon atoms in a conjugated cycle. So mari doubt raavachu mari ikkada kuda for example idu istanu. Okay, mari idi kuda homoaromatic avutunda? So one thing is conjugation is not possible here. Number two, this is possible in bigger rings only. In bigger rings only. That is bigger than six member rings only. Ikkada teesesam anko H teeseste normal aromatic avutadi. Are you getting my point? So this is also homoaromatic. Even sometimes it is called homoallyl, similar to that one. Basically, we know this is allyl, isn't it? Not only this one. This is also very much stable. In between there is sp3 carbon. Here also it gets stabilized. This is called homoallyl carbocation. Like this here, if the compound contains one or more sp3 hybridized carbon atoms in a conjugated cycle, this is sp3. Such a type of systems are called homoaromatic compounds. Remember, this is again homoaromatic compound. Okay. Then mesoionic compounds. What are mesoionic compounds? So they must be planar, and the heterocyclic betaines. So what is a betaine? Non-adjacent cation and cationic functional groups. That is, you will be having a plus charge and a minus charge. That should not be on adjacent atoms. Such type of things are called mesoionic compound. That is five-membered heterocyclic betaines. That means containing cationic and anionic functional groups on non-adjacent atoms. So overall charge will be zero. You will have plus and minus. Overall charge is zero. But so you will have charge separated structure. Permanent charge separation will be there. So best example is cignone. This is an important aspect. Aromatic system is most stable and anti-aromatic system is least stable. Then comes non-aromatic. Even homoaromatic compounds are also stable than non-aromatic. Many times they will ask a question. So what is the stability order or what is the energy order? You can do this way. So don't bother. I'll share this PPT later. So I'll explain with an example. I'll explain with an example. I'll not simply read out the points. You can take screenshot of, if you want. Take a screenshot of this one. I'll explain with the help of an example. Look at here. Right. What you do is take a circle, inscribe the polygon, say cyclobutadiene. So poly, that is, I have taken as a square. So this is a pentagon, hexagon, what you call this polygon or heptagon, can you say, like that. I am inscribing, circle lo inscribe chestunna. So inscribe the polygon, inscribe the polygon, then what you do, these are the molecular orbitals corresponding to each carbon. So how many atoms does it have? Five atoms. That means five sp2 carbons. So therefore, there is a conjugation. Conjugation must not be broken. So how many pi electrons does it have? Six pi electrons. So you will be following all the rules, Hund's rule, Abo principle, Pauli's rule, etc. All those things are valid here also. So therefore, six electrons are in bonding orbitals only. That is, there is a what you call as line in between the MOs. I'll repeat, M goes below the dotted line belong to molecular orbitals, and the M goes above the dotted line are anti-bonding M goes. So if there is even a single electron I'll repeat, even a single electron in antibonding orbital, it will be anti-aromatic. If all the electrons are present in bonding MOs, it is aromatic. Look at here. So even if an electron is present on the, what you call it as, on the line, that is dashed line also, that will be could be anti-aromatic. Look at here. So two electrons are present on the dashed line, MOs, so non-bonding, you can say. So this is anti-aromatic. So all are present in bonding orbital. So therefore, this is aromatic. So look at here. All the six electrons are present in bonding MOs. So therefore, aromatic. Again, aromatic. Look at here. So this must be. And two electrons are present in anti-bonding, non-bonding orbital. So therefore, this is also anti-aromatic. I'll repeat. So inscribe the polygon in a circle. Then take all the MOs corresponding to that. In between, in the middle of them, you draw a dashed line. So all the MOs below the dashed line are MOs, BMOs, that is bonding molecular orbitals. On the dashed line, non-bonding MOs, non-bonding orbitals actually. Then above the dashed line are anti-bonding molecular orbitals. If an electron is present in non-bonding or anti-bonding orbitals, it is anti-aromatic. If all the electrons are present in what you call as bonding MOs, it is aromatic. You can say also, if we have a closed loop, that means all are paired, aromatic. If one or more are unpaired, it is anti-aromatic. This way also you can conclude. These are called Frost-Muslin diagrams. So this is used to explain all other things. There is another called Craig's rule, particularly for non-benzenide rings, you will be using this one. What you do is check whether the molecule has C2 axis or not. Like C2 axis we have discussed in stereochemistry. Stereochemistry is important. C2 axis unda leda check cheyandi. Repeat Craig's rule etla apply chestam. Check whether the molecule is having C2 axis or not. You're getting my point. Then count the total number of double bonds. That is N. Are you getting my point? So what is N? First you check whether it has C2 axis. C2 axis undali andulo untane you can apply. Then count the number of double bonds. Count the total number of double bonds. That value is N. If N minus 1 is odd, it is non-aromatic. If N minus 1 is even, it is aromatic. It is silent on anti-aromaticity. Look at here. Yes, it has C2 symmetry. Double bonds count chain 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 only. 5 minus 1 ante 4. 4 ante even. Even means it is aromatic. This is azulene. Azulene is aromatic. This is heptalene. Count the number of double bonds or pi bonds. 6. 6 minus 1 ante 5 kada. 5 ante odd. Odd means non-aromatic. Yes. That's it. You can apply later. Take a screenshot. First C2 unda leda chudala. Yes, it has C2. Dinki C2 unda? Yes. Yes. So dinki C2 ila untundi. Okay. For this, they have a C2 like this. You can work out, take a screenshot. Remember, sometimes they will ask. So here you can see resonance energy is 36 kilocals. As such, resonance energy is increasing, but per ring is decreasing. So overall resonance energy is 36 kilocalories. Overall resonance energy is 91 kilocalories for this, for naphthalene, anthracene, and phenanthrene. So increasing, but per ring. So if you can divide to each ring, it is lesser than the benzene ring. So therefore, so higher the resonance energy per ring, higher is the aromaticity. So per ring, how much you have for benzene? 36 kilocalories. For phenanthrene, it's only 30.3 kilocalories. So therefore, this is less, the aromatic when compared to the benzene. In fact, this will undergo Diels-Alder reaction, if you can remember. This is less aromatic when compared to benzene. Even this naphthalene will undergo Diels-Alder reaction. That is, it will behave as a diene component. This middle ring will behave as a diene component. Afterwards, this will become aromatic, this will become aromatic. Remember this one. Okay. So some more examples. You can check which is mesoionic, which is, look at here. This, if you can write the resonance structure, దీనికి మీరే ఆన్సర్ చెప్పడానికి ట్రై చేయండి. టేక్ వన్ ఆర్ టూ మినిట్స్. త్రీ క్వశ్చన్స్ ఆర్ దేర్. యు ట్రై టు ఆన్సర్. Can any one of you? You can unmute option ichesa. Does it have aromatic character? Ila chudandi. Yes, it will become plus here. Are you getting my point? So therefore there is a continuous 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This pair is also part of the ring. So this is aromatic. Look at here. So once you can polarize this way, this will also become sp2 carbon. Though in such case, okay, isn't it? So this is also, why quite stable? Because you can say, what is the meaning of this one? Conjugate acid of this ketone. What is conjugate acid of this ketone? Add H plus. Jagrataga chusukondi. Question sariga chudandi. Conjugate acid of this ketone is quite stable anta. This is called conjugate acid. Why? Because cheppandi. This will acquire aromatic character. Ekkada aromaticity vaste akkada stability increases. Chudandi ippudu ikkada plus pettesam. So 6 pi electrons. So therefore it will become aromatic. Similarly, is very reactive compound, explain. So why it is very reactive? Because this is anti-aromatic. So anti-aromatic is least stable, highly reactive. Tell me, is it aromatic? In fact, can I call it as homoaromatic? Homoaromatic anacha dinni. Specific homoaromatic iyakapoyina kuda think that it is aromatic. Which is aromatic ante this is also aromatic. Doesn't mean that homoaromatic aromatic kaadan kaadu. Look at here, why it is not stable, why it is unstable? If you could polarize station, plus anti-aromatic. This will become anti-aromatic. So that's reason why unstable. Whereas here it will become
aromatic.
That's reason why it is stable. Even dipole moment they will ask. Which will have more dipole moment they will ask. Tell me first and second, which will have more dipole moment? Dipole moment ante then charge separation undali. You need to have charge. Itla indirect questions adugutarani chaala sarlu. Tell me, I'll write the dipole mean plus and minus charges. Ikkada rasta. Edi more stable andi? చెప్పండి ఫస్ట్ అండ్ సెకండ్ విచ్ ఇస్ మోర్ స్టేబుల్
ఫస్ట్
సో దేర్ ఫోర్ హియర్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఇట్ ప్రిఫర్స్ టు బి ఇన్ డైపోలార్ స్ట్రక్చర్ దిస్ డజంట్ ప్రిఫర్ టు బి డైపోలార్
స్ట్రక్చర్
ఎస్ సో ఏ విల్ హ్యావ్ మోర్ డైపోల్ మూమెంట్ అట్లా కూడా అడగవచ్చు అర్థమవుతుందా సపోజ్ ఈ క్వశ్చన్ ఇంకోలాగా అడుగుతానండి ఇది చూడమ్మ దిస్ ఈస్ బికమింగ్ అరమాటిక్ కదా వన్స్ ఇట్ బికమ్స్ డైపోలా దిస్ ఈస్ అరమాటిక్ కాబట్టి ఇది ఇలా ఉండడానికి ప్రిఫర్ చేస్తారు దిస్ ప్రిఫర్స్ టు బి లైక్ దిస్ వెరాస్ హియర్ ఇఫ్ ఇట్ గెట్స్ పోలరైజ్డ్ ఇట్ విల్ బికమ్ యాంటీ అరమాటిక్ ఇట్ విల్ నాట్ ప్రిఫర్ దెన్ కొన్ని డబ్బులు ఇచ్చేసినా నీకు ఆ ఫుల్ బిర్యానీ పెడతానా కూడా ఇలా ఉండడానికి ఇష్టపడదు వై బికాస్ దిస్ ఈస్ అన్స్టేబుల్ రిగెటింగ్ మై పాయింట్ సో దట్స్ హౌ ఈ క్వశ్చన్ ఇంకో క్వశ్చన్ ఇట్లాంటి క్వశ్చన్ డిఫరెంట్ వేలో అడుగుతాను నేను ట్రై టు ఆన్సర్
సార్ డైపోల్ మూమెంట్ అంటే చార్జెస్ సెపరేట్ మాడదా సార్
yes we need to have charge separation structure
okay sir okay
dipole ee question di question will get the answer idvarke cheppa
yes sir
yes look at here now tell me I will add silver nitrate which will give instantaneous precipitate done
silver is precipitate
no silver nitrate I am adding to both first one and second one which will give yellow PPT. Sorry, chlorine ante white PPT. Doesn't matter. First and second, A and B. Which will give immediate PPT?
B, sir.
Why this will become aromatic? After loss of B, it will become plus. Isn't it? So it will become positively charged one. So this is aromatic. This is anti-aromatic. Which prefers? Anti-aromatic doesn't prefer. So this will not give precipitate. So this will become what you call as easily gets ionized. This will easily gets ionized or gives immediate precipitate. This way also, so ఎప్పుడైనా గుర్తుపెట్టేసుకోండి when something has come, carbocation or carbanion or dipole moment, alvolysis, SN1, even what you call as elimination, that is particularly even elimination. Think of aromaticity also. Directly, sometimes they are, may or may not cover as aromatic species. So, these are some more examples. You can try. Yes. What is the order of aromaticity?
Second one.
Benzene highest, kada? Then naphthalene, then
naphthalene. Yes,
correct, na?
Benzene
naphthalene. Yeah, just now I gave the question. Salvalsis are something like which will give immediate precipitate. So which will give aromatic species?
Three
aromatic. So four anti-aromatic. Four is least. Am I clear? Three highest, fourth least. Where is that? Three, four, and that. B and C options. Manam shortlist chesko. Then comes, this is a carbocation with bridged and not stable. This is also non-aromatic. After loss, I am saying, after loss of BR, I am saying, this is also not aromatic, I mean non-aromatic. But this is bridged, this is non-bridged. Which is more stable?
Who is non-bridged.
Non-bridged, sir.
So, JAM 2020 question. Arthamaindi kada? సో ఇక్కడ వన్ టూలు ఎందుకు ఇట్లా ఇచ్చేసాం ఐడియా వచ్చింది కదా సో థర్డ్ అండ్ ఫోర్త్ నో ప్రాబ్లం ఫస్ట్ అండ్ లీస్ట్ దెర్ ఇస్ నో ప్రాబ్లం బట్ బిట్వీన్ వన్ అండ్ టూ సో హౌ డిడ్ వి డిసైడ్ ఇస్ దేర్ ఎనీ ప్రాబ్లం సో వెన్ ఎవర్ యూ హ్యావ్ ఎ బ్రిడ్జ్డ్ స్పెషీస్ యూ కెనాట్ అకామిడేట్ ది కార్బోకేటన్ ఆర్ పాజిటివ్ చార్జ్ పెట్టాం ఇది ఈజీగా అకామిడేట్ చేయలేము యూ కెనాట్ అకామిడేట్ దిస్ ఈజీలీ ఆర్ గెటింగ్ మై పాయింట్ Right? Next, JAM 2019, yes. This is a different way. Just now I have asked about silver nitrate. SbCl5, this is again Lewis acid, isn't it? So everywhere you will get positive charge. So this will give you aromatic, this will give you anti-aromatic. This, what about this one? What about this one?
Aromatic.
Answer,
aromatic. Achai,
multiple answer type.
Sir, pH andre yenu sir
yeah
what is PH.
Pardon?
Aromatic A, PH, sir.
Phenol.
So what about this one?
Anti-aromatic.
So how come you are getting aromatic here? You'll get a anion here. This is acidic hydrogen, but not with base, with sodium metal you are getting. What about this one, H minus? Where this will attack H minus? One possibility is, so of course here it is there, but it cannot pick up this proton. But the only possibility is H minus attacks you. So there will not be any possibility of getting aromatic structure. So here you can get, So here it is a cation, here it is an anion. So is that okay? You can take screenshot some of the books. Most of you are asking. I'll share this anyway. So let us keep aside these things. For a while, I stop sharing this one. Now, I keep a full stop for aromaticity. And one more aspect they are asking in questions is the reactivity order, which are activating groups, which are deactivating groups, and what are other para director, what are some group, let us say chlorine is deactivating, but still it is other para director. Right? So within few minutes, I will discuss that one. Koncham melligane close chesestanu, no?
Sir, homoaromatic compounds and okasa chepara.
Okay, yes. I'll take this one, for example. See how many pi electrons are there?
Four.
If this is like this, there is no problem. But suppose, say, this is also, there is no problem. This is actually benzene. This is cyclohexatrienyl cation. There is no problem, aromatic. Now what I do is, I'll take another species, try to compare all the three. And going to compare cheskundam. Look at here. I'll take a positive charge here. That means this is also sp2. So till here there is a conjugation except to this carbon. Are you getting my point? Except to this carbon, all are having sp2 hybridization. So therefore they will be planar. Now remember, there are 6 pi electrons, means 4n+2 pi electrons. Suppose if only this carbon goes out of the plane. Suppose any plane lo unnayana na yokka carbon painaki ellind ankonni migilina n etla untai plane lo untai. So all are in plane except this one. So for the sake of aromaticity, for the sake of stability, what happens is this atom goes out of the plane bayatiki vellipothadi idantha itla undesi. So mottham malli rayadam kashtam kabatti em chestha ante something is. So all the 6 pi electrons will be moving this way except this carbon. So that carbon goes out of the plane of the paper. Endukante mana planarity is a must for aromaticity. So such compounds are called homo aromatic compound. That means if there is one sp3 carbon in between a cyclic conjugated polyene with aromatic framework, then it is called homo aromatic. And aromaticity una conditions anne undale, but there will be one sp3 carbon that will be going out of the plane la undadu adi pakkana untadu adamaitundi.
Okay,
so shall I continue chedam? Okay, 30 minutes la chesedam, 6:30 I'll stop it. Speed ga ellipodam koncham, na kuda koncham padandi guest, some guests are coming, vallu vastunte kosse paap anna ippude vastha ante expect cheyala, em program ledu ani class pettukona, but don't worry, one topic will be completed. So recording avutunda? Okay great. Right, no problem. So reactivity of aromatic hydrocarbons, let us look at. So we know aromatic hydrocarbons, say benzene, will undergo electrophilic substitution reactions. Why? Because benzene is electron rich, particularly it has pi electron density, means nucleophilic. Benzene is nucleophilic, simple. So therefore it will attract electrophiles, and we know this will is a special property or characteristic property of aromatic compounds is substitution reaction. So therefore benzene will undergo, not only benzene, other aromatic hydrocarbons will undergo electrophilic substitution reactions. First point. Now tell me, suppose if I am going to increase the electron density by means of some other groups which are donating the or activating the nucleus. So naturally they will increase the electron density. More electron density means more nucleophilicity. More nucleophilicity means more reactive. That's it. Those are called activating. That is, benzene nucleus is activated. Ekko activated. Ekko chesindanki endukante electron density ekku undi. So in simple words, electron donating groups or electron releasing groups will increase the rate of electrophilic substitution. Such groups are called activating groups or activators. Opposite is the case with the electron withdrawing groups. So electron withdrawing groups will deactivate the ring. So activating rings means electron releasing groups. They will increase the rate of the reaction. Deactivating groups will decrease the rate of the reaction. So they can ask, which is the before giving an example, benzene, I'll take a mixture of benzene and toluene. Remember, methyl group is activating. Aa point ku nenu icha ippudu nenu benzene and toluene rendu teeskunta. I'll take a mixture of benzene and toluene. I'll try to nitrate the mixture. So which gets nitrated, benzene or toluene?
Toluene.
Suppose I take benzene and nitrobenzene, which gets nitrated again further substitute?
Benzene.
Why? Because benzene, sir. It is relative. Mari ippude toluene ani chepparu, now why are saying benzene? Because that depends upon the relative rates. Excellent. Very good. That's what exactly we are going to discuss. Sometimes they will ask, try to remember this. Strongly activating groups are these. What are those? NH, OH, and NR2OR. These groups are strongly activating groups. We'll have a pair of electrons. Suppose if you have O minus undi ankonde ikkada. O minus spectrum. So wonderful activating group, O minus. So it has 6 electrons. Okay, if there is O minus, it is further activated. Okay, then moderately activating are these. So this amino group is acetylated. Alcohol group is esterified. So its reactivity little bit decreased. Why? Because this will be in conjugation this way also. యూ కెన్ ప్రాక్టీస్ ప్రాక్టీస్ చేయాలండి ఇట్లాంటివి ఇది ఎట్లా వస్తుంది కాంజుగేషన్ ఇటువైపు కూడా వస్తుంది సో దేర్ ఫోర్ ఇట్స్ ఎఫెక్ట్ విల్ బి డిక్రీస్డ్ లిటిల్ బిట్ సో దేర్ ఫోర్ దట్స్ రీజన్ వై దీస్ ఆర్ moderately activating so because of high electronegativity halogens are deactivating groups they will decrease the reactivity so all minus m groups are without any exception are deactivating groups and particularly strongly deactivating groups remember so halogens and all minus m groups are deactivating groups Now let us look at the directing influence also we know which is more reactive which is less reactive somehow we have answered also so when you are taking a dye substitution already there is one substituent you if you want to add the other substituent it will direct the incoming group to some other place I'll give an analogy so after getting seat in some say campus IIT Hyderabad campus or IIT Bombay campus or Delhi campus say suppose you are given a sharing accommodation suppose one of your friend already occupied the room naturally what happens he will have the entire choice he may take the what you call as window seat or he may take wherever he want but second person has to be decided by the position of the second person has to be decided by the first one he will direct the first person will direct why because already he has occupied some space he will direct okay go to this place by virtue of his position he will decide or he will direct the other incoming group second incoming group to occupy in one of these places in relation to this one this fellow will direct either to come this way and this is called ortho and it can direct the second incoming group that is electrophile to this place you called as meta this place it is called as para then can any one of you tell what is this is called this position so this is ortho okay but direct nucleophilic substitution తీసుకుంటే ఈ ప్లేస్ లోకి వచ్చేస్తదండి what is this position called
ortho sir
ortho
is para sir this is ortho this is meta this is para ఇక్కడ ఇచ్చా నేను same position half the substituent has to be removed by and replaced by something else a place లో b పెట్టిన what is this called substitution
reaction
అదే నాన్న What is that position called?
Para.
Para.
Para. This is para.
Phenyl.
Enti.
Ipso, sir.
Yes. So electrophilic substitution it will not happen, but in nucleophilic substitution it will happen. The same position is called ipso. Right. Okay. Already explained this one. Yes.
Sir, one second.
Now let us explain why it is happening. Why nitro group is directing the incoming group to occupy the meta position only. So for that you need to examine the intermediate sigma complexes. This is called sigma complex or arrhenium complex. First, let us say attack the electrophile at ortho position, then meta position, then para position. Look at here. So this is electron withdrawing group, and the positive charge is being localized here in one of the resonance structures. This is unstable. Here again, this is unstable. Whereas positive charge is not residing where electrophile is attached when it attacks the meta position. That's reason why. Minus m groups direct the incoming group to meta position. Are you getting my point? If it is coming to ortho position, so highly unstable structure. One of the structure is highly unstable. Look at here. So highly unstable. Where is this one? Highly unstable. So this is relatively stable. I cannot say this is stable, but when you compare with this and this one, this is relatively stable. So therefore, all minus M groups will direct the incoming group to the meta position. Next. Say, activating group, say, methyl group. See, look at here, this is highly stable. Why? Because electron releasing group will stabilize the cation, carbocation. So therefore, at ortho and para positions, if the incoming electrophile, the second electrophile is coming, you are getting a very stable sigma complex. So therefore, they will direct the incoming group to the ortho and para position. Relatively, this is less stable. Even if we take NH2 or OH, in fact, that will be stabilized by mesomeric effect, NH2 kuda. Ikkada chuste ganaka. Practice cheyandi, idi compulsory. Inka adagochu. Sorry, objective type kada, practice enduku ani. Practice cheyapothe exam la correct cheyalem. Enta practice chesthe meeku anta perfection vastayi. Yes. Already we have seen kada positive charges here. So the positive charge is stabilized even for plus M groups. Then what about chloro? So why it is, even though it is deactivating, why halogens are ortho para directors? If you can remember in the table which we have taken that halogens are deactivating. No doubt ledu. Less reactive. Chlorobenzene is less reactive when compared to benzene. Methylbenzene is more reactive when compared to benzene. I'll repeat, chlorobenzene is less reactive, but still ortho para, why? Mesomeric effect. Same thing. So this positive charge is stabilized by the non-bonding electrons. Okay, so only halogens are deactivating. In spite of deactivating influence, they will be ortho para directors. ఒకసారి ఇది చూసేసుకోండి ఒక టూ ట్రై టు కీప్ దీస్ థింగ్స్ ఇన్ మైండ్ ఇట్స్ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ Okay, so let's take a question. So basically, but are moderately activating NHCOCS3. So there is some problem with the key, but actually this is moderately activating, strongly activating, strongly activating. These are deactivating groups. Third one and fifth one are deactivating groups. This is HCU question. Yes. What is the answer? HCU
2009. 4312.
B, sir. So 4, yes. This is strongly activating. Then moderately activating.
B, sir.
Deactivating. So 4, 1, 3, 2.
D 4, 1, third.
Yes.
Tallin.
So if you have koncham patience unte, shall I continue this? Many times we'll confuse with tautomerism and resonance. Shall I continue?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
For 10
yes,
more sir. Minutes. This many times will confuse with resonance and tautomerism. I think in 2020 also there is a question I couldn't clip. You work out later. Which of the following are resonance structures? There is a question you work out and you can ask tomorrow. So there is a question in 2020. I didn't clip that. A question clip cheyaledana. Yes. So what is a tautomerism basically? It is prototropy. What do you mean by tropy? It means migration. Migration of what? Proton. proton migrates through a pi bond framework. Look at here, this H will migrate via, that is through pi bond, and moves to another place. So hydrogen atom migrates from one number one atom to the other atom in a sigma and pi bond frameworks. Here, look at here. This H is attached to nitrogen, will move on to the oxygen. This is again called as tautomerism. Tautomerism. The best example is ketoenol tautomerism, but there is also observed in the nitro compound, nitriles and the nitro compounds. Then in this is the very famous, we also know, but this is also tautomerism. Okay, so even you call it as here again you are having same thing, you are having a prototropy, proton is shifting from here to here. So already we have seen Se form and nitro form, isn't it? So therefore when CH sigma bond is broken and migrating towards the more electronegative atom, sometimes it is called as what is known as keto, when tautomerism, when you have enol, you call it as ketoenol. This is very famous. Ketoenol tautomerism is very famous. Okay. There will be an equilibrium. Remember, some books they will give them as isomers, but they are not isomers. Why? Because isomers have a distinct existence. Isomers separate existence, they don't exist separately. So these are interconvertible. Isomers are not interconvertible, except conformations. So tautomers are not isomers basically, but if they give at all, you can tick yes. So there is an equilibrium. So depending upon the stability, the equilibrium lies. In ketones, most of the times, it will be existing in the form of ketone only, but depends. I will check some. Then in what way resonance structures will differ? So, in tautomerism, the atoms will change their positions, at least one atom, hydrogen atom. But in resonance structures, the position of atoms will not be changed, isn't it? So, tautomers are definite compounds. So, sometimes they could be isolated. For example, enol could be, if you add some base, it will you will be getting enolate ion, that could be isolated. So whereas resonance structures are imaginary, so they don't. Tautomeric forms will have different functional groups. Keto, let us say, ketone functional group, whereas in enol, you have en and ol, different functional groups. So there will be a dynamic equilibrium between the tautomers. What do you mean by dynamic equilibrium? One will be moving or getting converted into another with a faster rate, very fast rate. So tautomerism has no effect on bond lengths. Bond lengths will not change in tautomerism. Whereas in resonance forms, there will be a change in bond lengths. Tautomerism doesn't lower the energy, whereas the resonance decreases the energy. As the number of resonance structures increases, naturally stability increases and energy decreases. These are some differences. Let us look at some examples. Yes. So what is the order of stability? We have in the other, when you are discussing resonance, we have also discussed the stability of resonance structures, isn't it? We have also discussed the stability of resonance structures. There is no charge separation, most stable. If at all there is a charge separation, so there must be less distance and also negative charge and more electronegative atom. So therefore, this is most stable. Then comes this, then comes this. So one is greater than, three is greater than. Is that option is there? Yes. You can work out these also. Take them as homework. Take screenshots. Work out this. Take screenshots. Work out this. So white atomism is not possible in this way because alpha hydrogen is a precondition for tautomerism. Alpha carbon, I mean hydrogen on the alpha carbon. There is no alpha carbon. There is no alpha carbon. There is no alpha carbon. Many times this example comes. We confuse with this. This is quinone. But tautomerism is not possible. Okay. How many of the following compounds will exhibit tautomerism? Multiple answer type. Work out. Once it has come. You check. My answer is 6. It may or may not be correct. Sometimes it may be wrong. You check it. You correct it if I'm wrong. Work out. Tautomerism is not shown by
B.
So work out this also. So